Last June 1, the Philippine government allowed sports such as tennis and golf to resume play, assuming clubs and communities apply safety restrictions. Let's get a perspective on the new health protocols and the new normal in local golf from Philippine team head coach Mico Alejandro. Coach Mico, since GCQ started last June 1, what has been the status now of the golf community in the Philippines?
Golf has actually been starting up. We're actually one of the first sports that have been allowed to play and go out back on the field. And it's actually been very encouraging. I mean, it's a little bit different from what most people know as far as traditional golf. But, you know, everyone's able to go out and clubs are starting to open their doors again. So it's been good, slowly but steadily getting back to somewhat of a normal state.
You mentioned somewhat of a normal. What is happening now? Are there limitations in terms of players coming in? Also, what have been the safety protocols that you've observed?
So there are kind of baseline safety protocols set by the IATF. And a lot of the clubs, actually all the clubs are following it. So they've been giving, travel history, the waivers when you come into the clubs. One of the biggest differences I've seen is everything has to be scheduled before you arriving to the club. And of course, they've limited the number of people able to play. Another difference that I've seen is a lot of the F&B outlets aren't open. So it's pretty much you come into the club, you play around, and then they want you as out of the club as possible. So really trying to maintain the social distancing aspect of playing and trying to keep everyone safe. As far as differences in actually playing, it's about the same. Caddies are limited in their interaction with you as far as assisting and all that. But as far as playing the game, it's kind of stuck to its origins, so to speak.
All right. So for the 3 months, of course, Manila, Metro Manila at least, has been placed under the enhanced community quarantine. Many jobs were lost and many people were sidelined. How exactly did the golf community support these people, trainers, caddies, staff, and to be able to give them support and to give them a living?
Yeah, it's actually been really tough across the board, I guess with all industries. I don't think anybody's been immune to the effects of this pandemic, but the clubs have actually been very proactive in helping their staff individually. So they've done a lot of fundraising within their membership. And I believe some clubs have also assessed their members so that they could give back and help the caddies and their employees just to keep it going or paying it forward almost. And as difficult as it's been, it's very encouraging and uplifting that, we're slowly getting back into the groove of things and caddies are, getting back to, going out and making an income. Clubs are, slowly starting to open. So it's been good. As far as, training on my side, on the national team, it's obviously been tough. We were stuck at home, so there's zero golf happening. But we tried to make most of the situation and focus on the things that we could, like fitness and our mental game and stuff like that.
I can just imagine, Mico, amongst your peers and your buddies in the golf community, that everybody's been itching to really go to the golf course. What has been the behavior like leading up to June 1 and the knowing that the government will ease restrictions and allowing players to be able to go to courses already?
Everyone was so excited, and I'm part of that. I played once the GCQ or ECQ was lifted, and it was like the first day of school, and it's the same story where you're preparing your food so that you don't have to get food from the club. You have multiple bottles of water, you have your alcohol in your bag now, you have your mask and everything. So it was very exciting, and for our players on the national team, it was almost a relief of sorts. And for some people, the 3 month time at home was very difficult, especially in the golfing world for our players, you know, you're used to being outside 10, 12 hours a day, whether it's training, practicing, and then all of a sudden you're confined to a small space. There definitely was an adjustment period. And especially now as things ease up, my players are starting to play a lot more.
I must imagine that during the lockdown, Coach Pico, the work doesn't stop. In the advent of online learnings, online meetings, what has it been like for you as a mentor to your players?
You know, as far as the national team goes, we continued to meet at least once a week via Zoom. So we get everyone together. And actually, we still continue to do that despite the ECQ being lifted. And it's actually been a good kind of get together. And, you know, it's really maximizing the situation that we're in. You know, my mantra to my players is, you know, controlling the controllables. And, you know, this was one big situation we had no control over. So it was kind of figuring out what we could do to maximize what we have. So for a lot of us, it was strength and conditioning. It was focusing on areas where we might not be too sharp in. So the mental game, the mental aspect, the personal development, which I think is huge, you know, whether they're on the golf course or off. And, you know, for some, it was really exploration, you know, getting into hobbies that they never had an opportunity to get into, or maybe getting ahead of schoolwork for the ones that are still in school. So, you know, as negative as it was as a whole, nandun eh, ika nga. So, you know, we just try to make the most. And now that things are opening up again, you know, everyone is in high spirits, high hopes.
Coach Mico, now in this current situation, how do you train your players now? Of course, mass gatherings should be avoided in the advent of one-on-one trainings. How is it like now for you?
Yeah, so we, like I mentioned, we do have our Zoom trainings. And, well, they're more get-togethers than actually trainings. We don't really physically hit golf balls when we get together on Zoom. But now that people are allowed on the golf course, what we've been doing is we've been doing trainings more on a one-on-one individual level. So what happens is players will let me know what facility they're going to be at. And then I'll just make my way there and then we'll meet individually, work on things, you know, whether it's long game, short game, whatever it is, or maybe out on the golf course. That way we kind of, we're going away from that mass gathering aspect. And we're fortunate that we can actually do it for golf, diba? It's very individualistic. As much as we're a team, we do kind of everything on our own. The battle is against ourselves, so to speak. So trainings, you know, slowly, maybe in the next couple of months, depends on how things shape up. We might start doing some trainings together, but for now, there's really no rush, especially because of the international landscape where we don't know when tournaments are going to start. Even locally, we don't know when tournaments are going to start. So for me, for us, there's really no immediate rush to get back into training full on. We are as productive, or actually might even be more efficient sometimes, doing things on our own and working on things individually.
Coach Mico, the Philippine golf team has a more unique situation compared to the other national teams because you have players that are actually based in the States, study in the States, of course have Filipino blood and are Filipino in them. And at the same time, they're studying there and pursuing their career in the States. But now what has been the landscape for your players, especially that the NCAA was also canceled? What has that been like, and also for their future, and how do you mold them?
It's a very interesting situation that we have with golf and the national team. So like you said, some of our players, actually about half of our team, is US-based. And they're US-based because they are pursuing college degrees. Most of them are, actually all of them, are on college scholarships for their respective universities. And that's kind of been the stepping stone into the pros, just because of the competition that they have in the NCAA being a little bit better than what we have here locally. So it's kind of a balancing act on our part, you know, balancing our players there and still having a good base of grassroots players that we can develop. And for me as a coach, my goal is actually for them to go to the States and, you know, get better education and training there and, you know, potentially turn pro. So it's been a little bit difficult because some of them even coming back was difficult just getting on flights. It was so uncertain. Majority of them are here now. But it, like you said, moving forward, even going back to the US just because of, you know, their take on COVID, it's very loose, if you want to call it that. So tournaments are opening up there slightly, but they haven't been so strict on the safety protocols. A lot of our players are, they're kind of unsure if they even want to go back for their coming semester just because, you know, because of the health issue, because it is a real risk. And, you know, we've seen it where the numbers are continuing to rise just because as you ease up, you know, it's inevitable. So there's that aspect to it. But as far as planning goes, their schools and universities are already planning for tournaments. For them, the bigger question mark is the international travel. How are they going to get back over there safely? So that's the interesting part with our US-based players. But for now, they're here. We're training them. I mean, all of them were born and raised here in the Philippines. So this is still their home. So, you know, while they're here, we're trying to maximize their training so that when they do go back to the US or when we have bigger tournaments opening up here, we're ready to play.
You mentioned, Coach Mico, control the controllables, and more or less the golf community and the golf team is not really in a rush because of the uncertainty, and you're just improving on what you can improve now. But that being said, and also with the uncertainty moving forward, how do you think Philippine golf will be now in the future?
You know, I've said this before, the future of Philippine golf is very bright. We have a lot of young players and we have people in place in our NSA that have really been driving the development of the game, not just for the grassroots level, but for everyone as a whole. So, it's very bright. Actually, as negative as the whole pandemic was to the whole community, it gave us an opportunity to fix kind of the back end admin stuff and establishing our grassroots programs and, you know, the rules and regulations for a national team, you know, a national ranking system and stuff like that. So things that we weren't able to establish before, we were actually able to put some of our attention to. So really it's forward looking and really trying to start a system in where, you know, the development of the kids are at the forefront and, you know, we can continue to progress as a nation. So,
all right. On that note, Philippine Golf National Team Head Coach Mico Alejandro. Coach Mico, thank you so much for joining us here.
Thanks for having me.